You know, Nate, of course, you know, he's he understands pretty well. You know, I think he needs to go out there and just go out there and take some chances, push the ball down the field a little more. I think Riley puts the ball down the field really well. Sometimes he gets put in some tough situations. And then I think Aaron Bailey, you know, slow. You know, we got to keep him slow and you know, don't get him discouraged and make him understand. Because sometimes there's just so much stuff going on. But all three of them are really progressing really well. It's a great group. You know, with the meeting time when we come out here, it's just nice to watch the practice, but then I could just talk football for 50 minutes at a time. You know, Wes made a real nice comment, you know, hey, he's going to talk more football in about the last 3 or 4 days. And they did a great job out there. It's just that we have to teach that stuff. So it's been good.
Can you give Bailey enough reps to kind of slow him down, so to speak?
Well, the biggest thing is the quality reps. You know, when you don't ask him to do anything he can't do. So when you're scripting, you know he's in there, give him what he can be successful. Let him grow from that. And that's what we try to do. You know, little bit more of a movement type for him.
Coach, who would you say right now on the offense is the most game ready? And not necessarily even quarterback, but if it's a quarterback, then so good.
Well, you know, it's probably, Corey Lewis is probably the guy. You know, he's been through a lot. I mean, the guy's been here 15 years, and, you know, he should be game ready up there. And I think the offensive line is starting to play pretty well. I think that, you know, the stunts that they got, I think A.J. Ricker's done an unbelievable job with those guys there. You know, we're still a little work in progress, probably in the perimeter. I think that, you know, the running backs, they're getting pretty close because they've had a lot of experience with Deion and Fergie. You know, it's really, with Nate, it's just a point of him getting really comfortable, and Nate and Riley and Aaron.
Howard Griffith was saying that it's an extreme luxury when you have an offensive coordinator that can bring in his offensive line coach, and that's kind of how it happened. Can that be emphasized enough, how big of a luxury that is for you?
Well, it's huge for me. I mean, first of all, I coach AJ, I coach with him. I trust him, and he's like a second son to me. And he goes out there, he thinks exactly the way we think there. He just goes out and works. He's a great offensive line coach, even at a young age. And somebody said there's a bright future. No, he's pretty good right now. And he understands what we're trying to do. And it takes a big load off of me. I don't have to teach the offense expected.
Some of the press clippings about you this week, I mean, you're kind of the offense whisperer. A lot of people are saying that, this is the guy that's going to get this offense turned around. I'm sure you probably don't read any of that, but what's sort of been your take on how far you've been able to bring this offense along?
Yeah, my deal is, I came here for one reason, just to help Illinois win. And we're all in it together. It's not my offense, it's the Illinois offense. I want everybody to be together, buy in. So, the last guy in the offense is just important as I am. And that's how I look at it. I want them to have fun, I want smiles on their faces. I'm having a time of my life out here. I'm enjoying it, I want them to enjoy it. So, if we could all rally around each other, it's a lot better than being decisive. I think everybody understands, one thing, everybody understands where the direction's going. And there's a clear plan with what we're doing offensively, but they're part of that plan. They're just supporters.
Coach, a lot of 7-on-7, 11-on-11 today. What are some positives you take away from today?
Well, it seems like when we play fast, we're pretty good. When we slow down a little, we struggle a little. And the motion, that we have out there. We just gotta play a lot faster tempo. And when we slow down, we seem to kind of bog down a little. So, that's one thing you always take out. But in the very beginning, you better go out there and perform and be efficient to get those first two plays and make sure you have positive gains. And that's what the big stress was today.
Do you have the whole playback book in yet, or is it still some more stuff you have to put in?
No, mostly all the core's in. Then we just take her here and there. We may tag her out. But everything basically is in. We don't really have any new schemes in there. We just, it's personnel, or it's maybe some motion, stuff like that.
Awesome. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.